We're not in sanctuary, we're in some spooky wet place. Welcome back to Borderlands! Yes, we're screaming. We're doing the Assassinate the Assassins side quest. Yeah. And we decided just fuck it, we're just gonna go right there. Because we could teleport right here from this handy dandy notebook, fast travel station.
Yeah, we also kind of felt like, camera fix. We also kind of felt like the last one we talked so much of it, we're like, maybe we should just go straight to where we need to have the action this time.
Yeah.
Because we like you guys, and we want you guys to keep liking us, too. So, that's the idea.
Hey, look,
man, I'm looking at stuff here.
There's me. You're not on the Wall of Shame.
I'm not on the Wall of Shame?
No, it's because you're DLC.
Aww. Wow, Maya is crazy valuable.
Well, look at Salvador over here.
Holy crap. Oh, he has 99 cents, too.
For his list of crimes.
Cannibalism? Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, he's a... Hold on, actually, you're still worth more than Salvador.
Am I?
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 7, 20. And he's 1, 2, 3, 99.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're still worth...
It's the 99 that threw me off there.
Yeah. And 99 cents. And then zero is worth a lot, too. For political assassination, interesting.
Zero's an interesting character. I almost played as him, so.
He's a...
Anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lot of blood here. And someone tore up things. An eye for an eye.
Bummer.
This guy's covering his face. Do you think maybe he got his eyeball ripped out?
Yeah,
hey,
that's
look,
what it
pizza.
Looks like. What? Pizza?
Yeah, Moxie's pizza.
Now this is an interesting... How does, like, one do delivery here? Like, I can't imagine these bandits would, like, go to Moxie. Because that's in Sanctuary.
You can deliver... There actually is a mission later on where we go deliver a pizza.
Really?
It's a side quest, yeah.
Oh.
It's a pretty good one.
Gotcha.
Oh, shit, thanks. I missed every shot.
Attack!
Here's Star Wars.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, he dead.
I'm not dead. I'm alive! And angry. I also needed some ammo, so I thought I'd charge down here and get some ammos. Oh, man, I'm trying to decide what kind... Like, as I'm developing this character, I like the idea of doing the... thing where it's like, when I kill someone with a grenade, I now get stronger guns. When I kill someone with a gun, I now get stronger punching. When I kill someone with punching, I get stronger grenade. Oh, hey-oh! I did not... Uh-oh.
Eat my ass!
Eat my ass! Woo! Oh, you got the item? God damn it.
It was a crap assault rifle.
You're a crap assault rifle, which is true. It would be very difficult for you to be an actual assault rifle.
Bang, 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 bang!
Wait, we gotta kill him with a pistol.
Do you have a pistol?
I do. I'm shooting him with one right now. Oh.
Exploded, apparently.
I got him. Yay, pistol!
Tattoos and mystical powers. A siren, specifically one named Lilith. The official reports say she died in New Haven, but I'm positive she's hiding out near Sanctuary. If you catch wind of her, tell me and I'll pay you enough money to build a mansion made out of other smaller mansions. Out.
I love that. Woo! Let's see. Can I use your weapon swaps for each stack of bloodlust? Yeah, you know what? We could try that. Or do I want to keep increasing my magazine? Yeah, I'll keep increasing my magazine. Alrighty then. Magazine, oop!
Gotta kill Oni.
Oni's the next one. Now, what is he? Sniper rifle. I have a sniper rifle, but it's not, like, available.
I got a sniper.
Do you have it, like, available?
Yep, I'm using it right now.
Gotcha.
And if we don't kill him with that,
I'll be sad.
It's just an optional objective.
I'll be sad.
Let's not make Kublai sad.
Exactly. Oh, Iridium. Nice. Fighting for my life.
You woke the wrong dog.
I like that. You woke the wrong dog. There's Oni. Sup, Oni? I'll bring him down to about... All right, now he's all yours. You handle the rest.
He's a pretty tough one. We'll see how I do, because I've been...
You've been filling him with bullets?
Yeah. And then he does this. He charges at you.
Oh, he's got a shield. Ow! Alright, yeah, you keep it at him. Wow. I'll stand in his way.
I gotta reload. Get...
There you go. Yoink.
Ooh, look at all the money.
You cannot, I repeat, cannot win a fight with them in one-on-one combat. You see Lilith, contact me immediately. I can handle her. You can't.
More pizza.
Me, yes. You know.
Pizza!
Have you had a piece lately?
Bound chicken. Wow, wow. All her puns. I want to see a male, like, sexy puns thing. Like, I think that would be pretty interesting.
Like a male Mad Moxie?
Yeah, exactly. But he doesn't have to be gay. He could be bisexual. I think that would be kind of cool. Bisexual, like, Mad Moxie character.
Or is Mad Moxie is bi.
Oh, she is?
Yeah.
Oh, good. It's about open-mindedness, peoples.
Borderlands is pretty good at that. They have several characters that are different sexual orientations.
Right. But here's the real question. Do you play as any of them? Huh?
Athena in Borderlands Derp. In pre-sequel.
Borderlands Derp? I love Borderlands Derp.
I'm not sure if she's bi or a lesbian. But she's two girls.
Gotcha. She likes the ladies.
Yeah, that's actually spanned upon in Tales from the Borderlands, which is that Telltale series.
Uh-huh.
She ends up as one of the characters from pre-sequel.
Gotcha.
I'm trying to think who else you play as. Because I'm pretty sure Hammerlock's gay.
He definitely has an elegance to him, and I could understand that being very true.
Well, I want to say in one mission, I think it was actually in pre-sequel, he contacted you briefly, and he talks about his boyfriend, so...
Gotcha.
There's another character, Janie Springs,
uh-huh.
for pre-sequel, who actually is the one that ends up with Athena.
Uh-huh.
And she's a lesbian. Her biggest thing is, though, that it's... Like, that's, like, her only character trait, is that she's a lesbian, so it's not done extremely
yeah.
well.
Yeah. That's oh goddammit. That's kind of one of the ironies of a lot of like you can't ever be like a lesbian just being part of who you are. It has to be like the defining trait about who you
yeah.
are. And I mean there people are getting better at it, but it's definitely needs improvement.
Yeah, there's a badass sniper.
Yeah, that's why I keep getting knocked
out. I will use you as cover.
Hey, that works.
I have literally one health.
I'm down again. Come on, Gus! Where's that back?
I'm back!
Please lock him.
Nice.
It's the SMG. Oh, I'm down. Something made a very squishy, gross noise.
There, I'm right behind you.
There's no barbecue till I say there's a barbecue.
There's no barbecue till I say there's a barbecue.
Boom. Nice.
That worked out really well. So
our next one is kill with melee, so that's all you.
Oh, I can't wait for that one. So yeah, it's and that, but that's a character development that people are getting better at.
Yeah.
Because at the moment, it's still like people like, especially in artwork, it's still hard for people to like understand how to correctly characterize somebody who's gender different. Because mm-hmm. I mean, in reality, if you are gay, you're pretty much the same as everyone else.
Yeah.
Just are into whatever gender, or if you're bi or whatnot. I dated a girl who was bi, and I had a really fun time because it was like, she's just, and it wasn't like, oh, sweet threesomes. It was like, she was just bi.
Yeah.
And, you know, she was.
Oh,
like,
that's you.
Oh, yeah, that is him. And, you know, I'm shooting him with a shotgun to get him halfway down first.
I'm down.
Okay, let me help you. Instead, let me punch you.
Oh, that'll be nice and comforting.
Yeah, you know, anything to help you out.
I'm stuck in the corner.
you know, it was one of these things where, like, my favorite thing with her, though, is that I could check out girls with her. All right, it's all me now.
Yep.
Get back here! Get back here! Get back here!
Got a couple of shots on him.
Yeah, he might need a few more tippy taps.
Yeah, this might help.
Oh, yeah, perfect. Yeah, I got him now.
Recording that might help you guys out with the siren. Observing the siren Lilith since the opening of the world.
Damn it!
What's it? Using iridium to enhance her natural state. Like, we always go for, like, mine. It's always crap.
I know. It's never orange or purple.
Once a legendary shows up, there's gonna be a fight. We'll have to actually have a duel for that.
Yeah, and I imagine I'll lose first thing.
Well, we can be fair and say no action abilities.
That could be interesting. She just said something about sirens and fried pickles.
Yeah. That their abilities, like my phase lock, apparently smells like fried pickles.
Oh, that's interesting.
I like fried pickles.
Do you?
Yeah, fried pickles are good.
Oh, gotcha.
What were we talking about before this?
Shoot. I don't know. I think we were talking about, being gay and being characterized as gay. Yeah. I was talking about a girl that I did who is bisexual. Yeah, so, it was really fun to be able to, like, this is one of my favorite stories that with her. Was we were ordering a pizza, and, we went to a place where it was, like, just like a pizza stand kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And it had a window for you to look in and talk to the person, and the window was kind of low. So if you look at the, as a sixth... Hey, class mods!
Finally got some of these. What's mine do? Increased burn chance. That's actually pretty good.
This is you know what? You can pick that up for the money. I'll share.
Yeah.
Yeah. What did I pick up? I got class mod max health. Nice. That's useful.
So talk about low window. I'm assuming this means looking at butts.
No, chests, boobs, actually. So, the way that the window was located, it was like you had to kind of lean forward to look through the, like, for the person to look through the window, and it also required a little bit of, as a 6 foot tall individual, it, you know, the top of the window was like, stopped at like my chest or so. So, it was, and then it's...
I'm 6 foot four, I know the feeling.
Yeah, there you go. So, it's like, it was kind of low. So, what happened is that she was on the phone or something, looking out away, and the woman who came up to the window, she comes up and leans forward and just, beautiful rack on this girl. Now, I get it, like, she's a wonderful person, I'm sure she was brilliant and smart, but that was the first thing I saw because there was literally a frame around her boobs.
It's a boob window.
It was a boob window, and it made me laugh. Like, I didn't laugh out loud because I was like, I talked to the woman, I ordered my pizza, and it was very attractive, and I was like, okay. And then so I went over to the girl's dating, I tapped her on the shoulder, and I was like, here, come over here with me. She's like, why? I'm like, just trust me. Like, you're gonna order, like, grab the pizza for me. She's like, why? I'm like, just, you'll understand.
It's woman a comes really up. Good pizza.
Well, I basically didn't tell her why I was having her grab the pizza. And then the woman comes back with her pizza, and then boobs completely framed by the pizza, and she goes, all right, here's your pizza, and the girl I was dating just didn't move, just was stopped, and I poked her, I was like, hey, she's like, oh, shit, sorry, yeah, thank you, and, okay, we gotta kill the next dude with the shotgun, but, that was this, oh, damn it.
I gotcha.
Thanks. And so basically, and then afterwards, we walk away with the pizza. She was like, "God, that was really hot," and I was like, "Yeah, like."
And now I'm down.
Oh, I'm down too. All right, we both go for the nomad. I got you.
I'll just keep shooting him.
All right. So okay. it was this moment. She's like, "Holy shit! Like that was so hot." And I was like, "Yeah, like that window was designed for that." And I have no shotgun on right now. So, but that was one of my favorite moments with her, just because it was kind of a bonding moment. Like, we were already dating, so we were already, like, attracted to each other and liked each other's personalities and stuff. But it was just this, like, moment of, like, I've never done that with a girl. And then, you know, when you're already dating someone, you already have, like, extra feelings for them. Mm-hmm. You using a shotgun?
Yep.
Okay, cool. You know, you already have extra feelings for them. And so it's kind of like, it's so much of a more of a close-knit experience when you get to share, like, oh, we both have the same type. Oh, we, you know, it's like, also we're dating and we have the same type.
My type is the one with boobs.
Pretty much.
Actually, so, I'll admit it, I'm an ass man.
I am an ass man as well, though I have anti-boobs. Woo, butts! It's, I am an ass man, but I, like, completely understand the boob thing.
Oh, boobs are great, too.
Yeah.
We sound like such classy people right now.
Boobs good, butts nice. I saw boob, it was fun. Yep, we sound like the most classy people. But remember, the whole point of this is us talking about how when you meet somebody who is bisexual or gay, that, or hell, asexual too, is, you know, I've met a couple people like that, they're normal people and just have a sexual preference in the same way that, like, people are, oh god, you're getting all the items, aren't you?
I only took two, I'll be frank.
God damn it. But, that these people are just like, ooh, items! Oh, I'm full! God damn it.
I knew that was gonna happen.
God damn it. Anyway, but that they're not, like, identified or related to by their sexual preferences. They are, like, they're sexual in the same way that, like, you're an ass man or a boob man. It doesn't mean people treat you differently. Like, you still, like, are a person. You still have likes and dislikes all the same. Mm-hmm. So, that's just kind of the point of our conversation, is to remind people of this fact.
I can make this point even more powerful by, instead of just using the ass man or boob man comparison.
Right, because that's pretty ridiculous of a comparison in the first place.
Well, I'm actually bisexual. So.
Oh, there you go. Boom.
At least, like, I've never been with a guy.
Uh-huh.
Because it's only something I really realized since I've been dating Caitlin, and I'm with her. Yeah. So, I'm at least bi-curious, like, it's not something I broadcast.
Well, I think you don't need to broadcast something like that. You also don't have to hide it either.
Yeah, it's one of things, like, I'll mention it if the situation is right for it.
Exactly. This would be one of those correct for it situations.
Yeah.
So, gotcha. I just for a moment had, like, this was totally a mean thought, but I was like, what if all of a sudden I started acting, like, super uncomfortable around you? Like, alright, dudes, thanks for watching. I get super scared. Oh, man. Hey, by the way, our timer actually did just end around now. So, yeah. So, trying not to be homophobic after making the homophobic joke. God damn it. I still will play video games with you, Gus. It has nothing to do with anything. It's the timer, I swear. Oh, man. Oh, do I have enough iridium? I do. Let's see, what's a backpack upgrade? There we go. I definitely need backpack upgrades.
Yeah.
The way that I just pick up everything.
Yeah, I wouldn't bother with the storage bank upgrade.
Right, because it's only a couple things.
It's two, and that's not even for the, that's for the, like, the vault. Wait, is it? I'm pretty sure it's for the vault upstairs.
Yeah, it's for the vault upstairs.
Yeah, that's not even for the one you can switch between characters, because I wish you could upgrade that one.
Right, that would be kind of cool. But I understand why they don't really do that.
Yeah.
Like, it makes sense that if you find something really great but it's too low a level and you have it prepped for your next dude.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to go with the Malawan.
Yeah, what I do is, like, if I get a legendary and, like, I'll use it until it starts not being effective.
Yeah.
And then I'll stick it in there for when my... Like, I come through on another playthrough, my character gets up to, like, level 28 or something, and it's like, hey, I can use this legendary grenade.
Right, exactly. That's the plan. Hey, let's do our outro now.
We'll call it an out. Let's hang out by this badass graffiti.
Aw, yeah. Well, I can't even read any of it. Oh, look at the pirate! The new face of Hyperion is a pirate! Mod it, drop it, pop it. Pangolin adaptive munitions. Oh, I like that. That's clever. Wanted all X Crimson Lance. For association of, wow, all X-Crimons and Lance. That's crazy.
Wanted, any and all Atlas Assassins. I'm pretty sure that's a...
Zero.
No, that's not Zero. I'm pretty sure the one on the left there is a...
Athena.
Yeah. I keep wanting to call her Maya. I'm Maya.
Yeah, it's the wrong person. Oh, this one's upside down. I have... creature something. I can't really read it.
Circle of Slaughter.
Who was he? He can be rebuilt. Restore Rich Flyder?
V8 truck. Totally not stolen. Big ass guns. $8,000.
Totally not stolen. Missing Jimmy Jenkins. LDR unit Jenkins. Oh, wait. He was from a mission. A couple. He got a personality in Borderlands 1.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's like, I'm fearing. He turns all like cowboy. Or is that in this one? Oh, shoot.
I'm trying to I think that was in this one. Because in this one, there's a couple of like ones like that, but they're not him. Like, we've got, like, later on, we meet Innuendo Bot, so.
Innuendo Bot?
Yeah.
Up your endo.
On that pleasant note, shall we call it a day?
Yeah, that sounds good. You want to be the one exiting?
Right. Ow. Between the eyes.
Ow. All right, exit, man. Exit for us.
Well, here's our exit.
Who okay, yeah. Except
no action skills.
No action skills. Ah! Ah! Ah!
Run, little rabbit, run.
Surprise! Ow. Oh. But the meat has been
proper. Aww. So I get to do the outro. Alright, guys. Kublai loses. Yay, me. I'm a gracious winner. There's a mattress on that roof.
Which roof?
That one.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Siren in the background.
Alright, you were saying?
The cops are coming for Kublai, so we're gonna have to end it here.
Oh, God, I gotta run! Bye, dudes!
He's still standing.
You got your exit?
Yep.
Alright.
Wind, feet, back, sun, sky, sexy face.
Woo! Bye!
Just like you.
Yeah, just like me.